Hi, this is Rich, and in this video I want to talk about Law of Attraction basics. Now, if you're like me, you might not be, but you've gone around and around about the Law of Attraction stuff. Yeah, no, it works, it doesn't work, it's a little bit lame, no, it's really good, back and forth. And I feel like it should work, but when I tried it over the years, right? So I decided that instead of throw the baby out with the bathwater, instead of throw out these great principles because it's not working for me, I would look deeper at the whole thing and see if I could find out what I wasn't getting or what wasn't being taught. Doesn't matter whether it was being taught and I wasn't getting it, or they weren't teaching it back there with the, you know, when it hit the scene, you know, the secret, law of attraction, the secret, everybody's watching the video, right? And capitalizing, commercializing on the whole thing. What was missing? Well, here's what was missing for me. Okay, you ready? This has to do with what you focus on and think about, you bring about. That's what we heard, right? What you focus on, you think about, you bring about. Here's what's missing in there. What you focus on causes you to think about something. Look, and you look over there and you see a beautiful babe. Wow. Okay, so you focus on the beautiful babe. Wow, she's hot. And that causes you to think about things. You're either going to think how you can score with this beautiful babe, or you're going to think about, oh yeah, remind me of all the beautiful babes in high school, and I didn't have a chance with them, and I don't have a chance with this one. See how it made you think about something? So we look at things. You look at a fancy hot car. Ooh, look at that nice car. I want one. See, it makes you, what you focus on, it causes you to think about it. Now, I am over talking the subject, like, duh, Rich, yeah, I know, yeah, you think about something, you talk. So you're focused on this video and the words I'm saying, and it's causing you to think things. Now, it may be positive things, like, ooh, yeah, Rich, ooh, yeah, tell me more. Or it might be like, ah, shut the fuck up, man. You know, it causes, what we focus on causes us to think about things. Now, why this is important in this video is because there's something that has been missing in the Law of Attraction teachings. As far as I'm concerned, it's been missing. Now, maybe it's just right there on the next page of a book that I haven't freaking read all the way through, right? Or it may be in a YouTube video that I just didn't click on. I'm just saying, for me, it's been missing. And here it is. You focus on it, it causes you to think about it, whatever it is. And right now, it doesn't, when you focus on it right now, whatever it is, it causes you to think something right now. If you're disciplined, you cannot think, right? You can do the quiet mind thing, but we're not talking about the quiet mind thing right this second. We're talking about normally, automatic response, you look at something, you think about it. Yeah, Rich, what now? Well, here's the big secret behind the secret. Hasn't everybody said that? Have you getting tired of that yet? The secret behind the secret. Hey, fuck you too. Why didn't you tell me that 5 fucking years ago, bitch? For free. Instead of me charging me fucking money for the goddamn thing. Now. Do you get angry like that? I do. Sorry. This is, I use the F word a lot for new people. And if it makes you uncomfortable, my videos probably aren't for you. I cuss a lot. Sorry. Okay, so, yeah. Here it is. You focus on it. You think about it. When you think about something, you feel something. Your thoughts, what you're thinking, causes you to feel something. And what you feel can be good, bad, or indifferent. But thinking will trigger emotions. What you think about what you're focused on will cause you to feel something. Okay. Is that simple enough? Well, you look at the beautiful baby. Hey, baby. You think that, right? But immediately you might think, ew, that's not going to work. Now, the thought that that's not going to work brings with it that feeling that where you lift up the lip and go like, that's not going to work. And you usually have that internal dialogue that goes along with the feeling. Somebody walks in, they got a new hair, and it looks like crap, right? And you focus on the hair. And just focusing on that really freaky hair makes you feel a certain thing. It's almost stimulus response, you see. But what you focus on causes you to think certain things. And then when you think those things, the thinking causes you to feel things. So here's the simple message in this video in under 7 minutes, and you can go after you get the simple message if you want. Simple message is that if you don't like how you feel right now, it's because, well, you're feeling how you feel right now because you are thinking things right now, because you are focused on certain things right now. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. So, let's just use me for an example here. Right now, as I'm speaking to you, I'm focused on what I'm saying and the reaction that you guys might be getting. And so it's an idea. I'm having a thought. Gee, what are they thinking about this presentation? Are they going for it? Are they interested? Am I oversimplifying? Am I repeating myself too many times? Are they starting to feel? See how my thought processes start rolling on automatic. We do not have to put any effort in what we think. We just start thinking and it just goes on and on. And we normally don't take control of what we think by virtue of what we focus on. We focus on something, we think about it, and we have a feeling. It's all automatic. We focus on something, we feel something. You see a pizza and you go, I'm having some fucking pizza. And you think, do I have enough money? Let me see. Do you have any buck? Hey, let's get some pizza. Want to? Right? And you have a feeling state. And so it's very important that I repeat myself many times, because this is profoundly basic, and it might be so simple that people are not going to get that it's really important. And I like to sound important, and I like you guys to think what I have to say is important and all that shit, right? Okay. So I'm having thoughts and it's causing me feelings. Okay. So here's what you can start doing to overcome how you feel right now if you don't like how you feel right now. Again, this is the simple version, because it's a little harder than it sounds, or it sounds easy, or it comes out easy. Oh yeah, that's easier said than done, right? But here's the thing. It becomes our responsibility, yours and mine, to be aware and conscious of what we focus on. And not just that. Like, see, I've done a lot of research on what's going on in the world. And I've found out a lot of icky things that are going on in the world. So I've focused on those things. I'm not saying it's good or bad. I'm saying I focused on those things. And it causes me to think things and then feel things. And they're what I'd call negative things that I found out about the world. So it makes me think negative thoughts. But one of the real important things is how it made me feel. And it makes me feel bad, depressed, like there's no solution. Like how are we ever going to get out of this? It's confusing. I feel confused. But it's by virtue of what I've been focused on and then think about. It's not just focus on. People in really good shape, they can focus on something beautiful or something ugly, something kind or something hateful, and they won't think about it. they will observe it. And if they don't think about it, they will not trigger a negative emotional response. They just look at it. Okay? It's called quiet mind stuff. But my point here is that most of us, most of the time, it's all automatic, and it's so crammed together, and it happens all so very fast, that it's not clearly stated in the teachings that I've looked at and studied as far as law of attraction goes. Because it's almost more basic than what we understand as the law of attraction. When you focus on something right now, it's going to cause you to think things right now. And that thinking is going to cause you to feel something right now. The attraction happens instantly. And I know the teachings, law of attraction teaching, is what you think about and feel about, you bring about. Yeah, that too. But let's shorten that. Let's look at the earliest part of it. What you think about causes you to feel about. See, that's not taught. As far as I know, that's not clear in the teachings. And whether it is or isn't, that's good. And I'm sure somebody else has been teaching these principles. So I'm not saying, hey, I came up with this first. No, I'm just doing a video on it because it's very important and I haven't seen it around myself. Okay. So when you think stuff, if you're doing your law of attraction sort of thing or ascension stuff, this is good to know. What we need to do is be more responsible about what we focus on. Because what you focus on will cause you to think things. And if you know that if you focus on that, it's going to cause you to think something that's going to cause you to feel in a way you don't want to feel, you did it. It's your responsibility. Okay? In the little picture or the big picture. Well, I have to focus on my job every day. I can't quit my job. Yeah, that's big picture. So we got to start little picture. What you focus on, if you focus on how you're not getting paid enough, that causes you to think things and feel things. The thinking causes the feelings. Hey, you know, I got passed up on the promotion. True. We're not saying what you focus on and think about is not true. We're talking about what you focus on and think about makes you feel things, right? So it becomes our responsibility to take a closer look at this. How does this work? Okay, if you want to feel better right now, you have to focus on something that causes you to think things, and the thinking that you do causes a better emotional response. You see? It's so damn simple. It's a short video. But on the other hand, I really want to talk about it. And here's why. It's easier said than done. I've had to practice and practice and practice and practice this. And it finally clicked. And for me, it's crunch time. We've only got a few months to the big 2012. What the hell is going to happen? I don't know. What do you think is going to happen? I don't know. What do you think is going to happen? Hell, I don't know. Ask him. He knows. Yeah, and he knows too. And they don't agree on what's going to happen. So what do we do? I'm getting more specific and more personal. It's not about what happens out there. It's what's happening in here, spiritually speaking. How am I doing? Is my vibration lifting? Well, a low emotion is a low vibration. If I want a higher vibration, it would be nice if I could have a higher emotional state. So, with that said, I'm going to end off part one here, and then we'll go into part two, more about how do we change our vibration by virtue of what we focus on and think about. And how do we change what we focus on and think about for the ascension experience to be a better outcome. Okay, be right back.